इस खबर के पेश करता है अरबियन जूसेस एंड सलाड्स।
सी आई हैव रिएक्टेड टू द स्टेटमेंट मेड बाय वेस्ट बंगाल चीफ मिनिस्टर ममता बनर्जी वेरिन शी सेड दैट हर गोत्रा इज शांडलिया एंड शी ऑल्सो प्राउडली क्लेम्स दैट शी इज अ हिंदू ब्राह्मण and throughout this election campaign she has been reciting Chandi Path, Durga Path. My reaction to her statement is that if she is saying that she belongs to an upper caste Brahman Hindu community and that too her gotra is Shandliya, then where should Muslims and Dalits of West Bengal go? Muslims compromise 27% and 22% are Dalits of West Bengal, who are not part of this Varna system. That is why I condemn her statement, wherein she is claiming to be from an upper caste. She is practicing same politics of communalism, which is being practiced by Narendra Modi and BJP. I don't find any difference between what she is saying in this election and in her election campaign and what BJP is doing. So Mamata Banerjee and Narendra Modi are made for each other. What is happening in Tamil Nadu also is very dangerous, because the DMK manifesto says that anyone who wants to go to temple yatras in Kashi or Mathura, various places, the DMK in the election manifesto says that they will give 25,000 to 1 lakh rupees. This is nothing, but everyone is trying to prove, whether it's Mamata Banerjee, Stalin or Narendra Modi or other secular parties like even Congress party, that who is a bigger and better Hindu. This is not good for our pluralism, for our diversity of our country. You are weakening the beauty of our country, its pluralism and diversity. And the last important point is that if this sort of competition continues on who is a bigger Hindu, whether it's Narendra Modi or whether it's Mamata Banerjee or Rahul Gandhi or Stalin, then you mark my words, in future India's politics will become like Israeli political parties, which what is happening in Israel right now. Every political party in Israel has become more ultra-Israeli and right-wing. That day is not far when that what is happening in Israel will be reflected in India's politics. That is why people should carefully exercise the right to vote. When it comes to these statements, it clearly shows the mindset of that particular leader. And they are taking everyone, every voter for a right in the name of secularism, in the name of pluralism.
Your party is contesting here. What is the trend you are seeing in Tamil Nadu?
We are in alliance with Mr. T.T. Dinakaran's AMMK. And we are contesting 3 seats. I am thankful to Mr. T.T. Dinakaran for making us part of his grand alliance. We are working hard for the victory of all the candidates. And I am sure that the people of Tamil Nadu, they are waiting for a third political alternative. People of Tamil Nadu are tied with ADMK because of their alliance with BJP. People of Tamil Nadu know that DMK is as opportunistic when they are in power. And that is why they require a third political formation. I am sure that in the leadership of Mr. T.T. Dinakaran, we will be successful. And I am sure that this time around, the people of Tamil Nadu will bless us and vote for the AMK and other alliance partner candidates.
The prediction says all the DMK seats will be, DMK will win the maximum seats in Tamil Nadu.
Sir, no one knows, no one has knowledge of future. These are all predictions. The reality will be different, inshallah. Thank you.
हमारे HN News को सब्सक्राइब करिए ताकि आपको नोटिफिकेशंस आते रहे वक्त पर।